It's always seemed to me that Australia is the lucky country, is a fantastic country for most people, but we excluded our Aboriginal people from the enjoyment of Australian life, basically. They were treated differently for reasons I could never understand or accept. The Mabo case was the most significant shift in the balance of power between Aboriginal people and the settlers since 1788. From 1788 to 1992, Aboriginal people were not seen as having an enforceable interest in country. And in 1982, Mabo changed that.
For the first time, Australia has recognised the legal existence of Aborigines prior to white settlement.
Native title are the rights that are recognised by the law that flow from people's connection to country. The connection to country is established by their law and custom. It's a matter of very patiently compiling lots and lots of information and evidence from groups of people who were scattered over a huge area. So my job was to bring together the parties and to talk about the application and to start the process of moving towards hopefully settling the claim by agreement. This was a dramatically sort of focused meeting because of the painting and the number of people there who were sort of enabled by the painting. They were unlocked by the painting. It was an extraordinary artifact for enabling people to talk. State government representative, who's a very experienced person in the field of working with Aboriginal people, was immediately said, well, you know, you'll get your native title.
The law says to all the people in Australia that this is your land and that it always has been your land. Congratulations.
The reality that Aboriginal people have rights which are intrinsic to them in their collective Aboriginal identities is established, and that's fantastic.